In the last video, we built a few stellations of the dodecahedron in an informal way, just to see what would happen. But if we want to be sure we found all of them, we need a more systematic approach. And that's where a stellation diagram comes in. A stellation diagram is just one face of the polyhedron, imagined as stretching out forever, with intersections with other faces marked. Let me show you how it works with the dodecahedron. Start with the bottom face, and imagine it extended out in every direction. Now pick another face and extend that too, until it cuts into the first face. Where they meet, draw a line. Now take another face. This one already shares an edge with the bottom face, so when you extend it, you just get that same edge, but now extended in both directions. And we just keep on going, one face at a time, adding those lines of intersection. There's only one face that never meets the bottom one, the top face, because it's parallel. Now clear everything else away and just look at those lines. This is the stellation diagram. The small pentagon in the middle is the original face, and the lines around it are all the possible intersections with the other faces. These lines divide the diagram into regions, each region being a piece you could include in a stellation. If we want to keep our stellation symmetrical, and we usually do, that narrows things down a lot. For example, if you take one of these orange regions, you have to take all of the other orange ones too, to keep the rotational symmetry. The same goes for these green ones, and these red ones. The remaining regions can be ignored as they extend to infinity. So really, there are just four sets of building blocks we can play with. Symmetry requires that each face is the same, so we can construct our stellations by taking the same selection of regions for each face. Take just the blue pentagon, and you get, of course, the original dodecahedron. Take all the orange pieces, and you get the small stellated dodecahedron. The green regions form the great dodecahedron. The red pieces form the great stellated dodecahedron. Now what if you try to combine them? Well, if you take the blue and orange together, you'll find that the blue parts end up completely hidden by the orange parts. By convention, we don't allow stellations with hidden face parts, to prevent us from ending up with multiple stellations that look the same externally. And so the blue-orange combination is not considered a valid stellation. The same thing happens if you try to combine the green parts with either blue or yellow. The green hides them and the stellation is invalid. And the red pieces also hide any other pieces they're combined with. So in the end, there are only four valid stellations of the dodecahedron. The original dodecahedron itself, and the three Kepler-Poinsot stellations. Turning to the other platonic solids, we begin with the tetrahedron. In this case, all its faces are already intersecting the tetrahedron's existing edges. So the stellation diagram is simply the original face, a triangle. There are no further stellations. The cube also yields no new stellations. The stellation diagram is again just the original square face. Since any extensions either meet in existing edges or remain parallel and never intersect. octahedron is a little more interesting. Its stellation diagram looks like this. In addition to the original blue face, we see three additional orange regions. These can be combined to form this elegant figure, the stellar octangular, a compound of two interpenetrating tetrahedra. Strictly speaking, this is only the outer shell of the stellar octangular. The true stellar octangular includes the full tetrahedral faces passing through each other. It is formed by combining both the blue and orange components. Finally, the icosahedron is in a class of its own. Extending its faces gives rise to this far more intricate stellation diagram, with many possible combinations and many distinct stellations. These will be the focus of the third video in this series. Thanks for watching, and see you then.